j'adore ma casemire. Je vous avoue que ça m'a pris beaucoup trop de temps ce matin de décider quel soulier porter. Quand je vais en ligne, ce que je vois, c'est des influenceurs et des célébrités qui influencent mon style personnel. On croit qu'à Boutique 2018, vous allez être capable d'aider vos clients à vraiment atteindre ce but-là, de pouvoir monter leurs idoles. Bonjour, mon nom est Nathalie, voici mes collègues Connor et Asher. Nous sommes ABI's Consulting et aujourd'hui, on va regarder à comment vous pouvez innover avec Boutique 2018 avec une stratégie marketing digitale. On va maintenant continuer notre présentation en anglais, mais vous ne vous gênez pas de nous poser vos questions en anglais ou en français. Maintenant, je vais passer à Asher pour le mandat.
So, why are we here today? Today, we're here to develop a digital marketing strategy that really, really brings Boutique 2018 to the forefront of your target market. So, you mentioned three key metrics that you really want us to focus on, which are the national awareness that you plan on developing with My Boutique, the customer base, and online and in-store sales, bearing in mind the cannibalization of this. So, the key considerations moving forward specifically to this mandate are the RCL values. At Reitman, you have values that you hold dear to your heart, and our recommendation really takes that into consideration moving forward. Second, the demand for your target, the demand that your target consumer is after. You gave us three target consumers, Steph, Mandy, and I forgot the third one, and Sarah. And you really want to be able to capture that target market, so our recommendation takes that as well. And finally, competition and cannibalization. How exactly do we differentiate ourselves, all while not alienating all the other brands that are within your portfolio? So our recommendation is My Boutique, a strategy that really positions Boutique 2018 at the heart of women's wear. So the goal is to really launch the rebranded website that you plan on launching in 2018 with an additional input of technological and analytics that will really push My Boutique forward. The three phases of this implementation, browsing. It's really to start developing the new website features that you will be incorporating into your website. Second, the fitting. Launching the My Boutique campaign that will really take every single target that you want onto your page and purchasing and adding to cart, which is the purchasing factor. So leveraging data to really have that add to cart result. Moving on to the analysis. It's very important to know that the millennial market is one of the growest, it has the strongest online purchasing power today, representing 60% of all online purchases. Another factor to keep in mind is that they also represent e-commerce sales are also growing at 3% year over year. So this is a market that Boutique 2018 really has to capitalize on in order to grow. Not taking advantage of this market right now really gives place to the competition, and that's something we absolutely need to avoid. So moving forward, Boutique 2018 really needs to move fast and push that marketing forward in order to capture a loyal customer base. Moving forward into the competitive analysis, you'll see that the main competitors that you have are Zara, H&M, and Forever 21. And Boutique is really positioned in the middle of this segment in terms of trendiness and in terms of price. But there are also other brands which are unboxed, such as Edition L, Pennington, RW Co, and Whitman's, that are within your own portfolio brands, that the goal is not to take their customers, but to really focus on acquiring new ones and building more market development within your own customer base based on your current product line. So moving forward, it's really important to rely on innovation to do so, because competing based on trendiness is very, very difficult given the presence of Zara and H&M and Forever 21 in the market. And also, to compete on price is not really within the value that Boutique 2018 represents. You are affordable, but you're also stylish, you're trendy, and you're a personalized aspect, and our campaign really does not want to remove that aspect from your market. So let's look at the comparatives in terms of the internal analysis and what exactly is going on in-store versus digital. So in-store, you have a 30% conversion rate compared to the 1.2 conversion rate online, which is a huge disparity. That means the experience that is really going on in terms of your in-store purchases is much different than your digital one. In-store as well, there is that portrayal of the RCL values. Online, it's not really filtered through. The values are not really exhibited, and that's an issue moving forward that, of course, our recommendation plans on remediating. So the in-store is really a question of experience, But we've also come to the conclusion that your online really has that additional reach that you need in order to build that client, that customer basis that is absolutely necessary. So if we manage to scale that in-store experience up to the digital platform, that is really the key success factor here. So in terms of the target consumer and Stylish Sarah, Martini Mandy, and Striving Steph, we've analyzed their behavior and their media habits. If we look at Stylish Sarah, we see that she's inspired by the celebrity fashion and she really values those unique experiences that she is able to find in store, but not really on the digital platform. And finally, in terms of media habits, she follows influencers and is always connected. So that's where we will be able to capture her, through the influencers and through the digital platform. In terms of Martini Mandy, she really cares about quality, wants to be involved with brands, and really posts pictures on Instagram and Facebook of what she's wearing and what she likes, and she connects and she leverages that to really promote that aspect to all her friends. So that's another connection that you can leverage. And finally, Striving Steph. Open to new experiences, really wants the clothing that really makes her feel good, and for her, shopping is an outing. She wants to go out and really feel that experience. Spends a limited time on social media and will only follow influencers that really resemble her. So having a wide variety of influencers after is not really the goal that will actually convert her to sales. So moving forward, I'll leave it on to Connor for alternatives.
Thank you, Asher. So when it came to alternatives, we came up with three options for you today. The first one really being retargeting from some of your other brands in terms of getting some of that customer base to really adopt onto your new Boutique 2018 launch. The second was really to go about doing this through the launching of an app. So to really have this online sales platform on an application for people to use on the go. And thirdly, was a clothing recognition technology and amping up your current offering by making it one step closer. And what we've seen in terms of the criteria is firstly, we base it on cost, awareness, congruence to your target consumer, and engagement. And what we've really seen on this is that in terms of the clothing technology adding into your feature, this is going to be the strongest to not only bring you greater customer engagement, but also a greater congruence to your target consumer. And it's for this reason that we've chosen this option as the way to go for your feature solution. Now diving into the recommendation. We've seen, as Natalie mentioned, a lot of these women, they're very involved in the shopping experience. But what if we could take that one step further and provide them some form of technology on your online platform that allows them to really address some of the needs and wants that they want in their style. Imagine they had the ability to be able to see similar options to their own style without having to scroll through and find it in a cluttered online way. This is what we want to bring forward with our recommendation at My Boutique. This strategy is really going to position Boutique 2018 at the heart of women's wear. And as mentioned, this is going to be doing through the launch of your rebranded webpage, but equipping it now with an advanced technology and different analytical capabilities. So that way you can really not only analyze the consumer, but also give some greater recommendations. We see this in three phases, one being the browsing phase, which is really going to be about developing that website in the back end and the start before the launch. The fitting phase is really going to be the launching of this online campaign. And thirdly, the purchasing. How are we going to really leverage this data so that way we can get greater add to cart and greater results in the future?
So now, we want to look at how this is actually going to work for you at Boutique 2018. So as you see on the screen, what we want is that when the person goes on their website, they can see the item that they want, and then next to it, get recommendations from Boutique 2018 that are similar to their taste and would fit them well. So our goal here is to have a software that would really enable the customer to send in the look that they want and get a recommendation personalized to their needs based on this picture. So how it would work for us, how we see it working, is that you would create your customer profile first. The customer would go on, log in through Facebook to have their customer profile. Then they would scan or submit a picture that they want. So they could do this through either taking a screenshot from an Instagram post, finding any picture they've found online, submitting it through their phone, or even scanning directly with a webcam of something they see in front of them, or such as, so that they can really get any clothing item they like and they see, they could get a recommendation from Boutique 2018. Finally, they would receive a recommendation personalized to their needs of a similar item. Nextly, we want how you're going to create the recommendations. So we want to, as I just mentioned, offer a personalized personalized recommendations to each customer based on what they truly want. So the first thing, as I just mentioned, is they create their customer profile through Facebook login. Secondly, the website will recommend them the alternatives. And then thirdly, because you don't have unlimited alternatives at Bootsik 2018, it's going to have a clickable button where people can see items from the other Ratemint brands. What this is going to do for you is that it's going to allow you to have less cannibalization of your other brands. So this is a great alternative, and you're going to be able to have a small integration of your other brands in case the customer doesn't find what he wants at Bootsik 2018. They can actually right away be transferred to one of Ratemint's other brands, which is really great for you as it allows you to have some customers who go cross different brands. Finally, if they forget an item in their cart, the website will automatically be able to send them an email since they have a customer profile with a discount of 10% off. So to make sure that they actually complete their purchase with Bootsik 2018, because it's great to have awareness, liking, and that they have found the product. However, we actually want to turn this into an actual purchase for you. So this is why you have this tactic. We also want to make sure that this is a seamless experience for your customers. You want to make sure that your online experience is great, but that your in-person, in-store experience mirrors that and is as great as that. So you want to make sure that your customer who goes online is as impressed with their experience in store. So what we recommend here is that your pieces that are actually in your store, your customers could also scan those with their phone to be able to really have that on the website and then be able to find it online. The benefits here are if ever there's a stockout of their size in the store, they will actually be able to find it and be able to order it online, so then they never have the option of having a stockout. They can always find the item that they want. Secondly, it will also be able to find other recommendations for them. If they're just looking for something similar, they will have it at their fingertips. Here we have a few metrics for you. Firstly, the number of scanned items. This is going to help you because you'll know how many people are actually going in store and on your online platform, so this is important for you. And secondly, also the number of purchases from your scanned items, because you'll be able to see your actual conversion rate. Now for a campaign overview. So this is all great to have this brand new rebranded website. However, you want to make sure that people are aware of it and that they actually come to your stores, come onto your digital website. So how are we going to do that? First of all, who we're targeting are the three customers you've pointed out to us. So Sarah, Mandy, and Steph. Our message to them is that your own personal stylist is only a click away, so that they can come on our website and be styled just with your website. Your slogan will be your style fit to you, to really fit with the fact that you're giving them recommendations for them, personally for them. And your hashtag will be dress it up, since you want to make sure that you build some following on what you're doing and that you keep the conversation going on your social media accounts with all your customers. Your tactics for this will first of all be digital billboards, which we'll go into more into detail later. Influencers, so we want you to partner with some influencers to do this. And finally, social media, so Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, all the platforms you're already working on. I'll now pass you on back to Connor.
Perfect. So now we see the vision of this. Having a woman being able to go online and scan their clothing and find similar suggestions. We see that this is something that they're looking for. They'll find an image online that they like, but now they can actually find references at your store that actually fit their needs. So now when it comes to digitalizing and being interactive with your consumers, you're going to be doing this firstly with the interactive displays and digital billboards. So how we see this is bringing the experience that you have on your computer or on your mobile phone now into a bigger area for people to try out and test out. So how we see is we're going to be promoting the website relaunch by really gaining the awareness through this of this new tech feature that we have. And how we're going to be promoting it is really making sure that we set up billboards and digital, where they can do the same thing as if they had their phone. So they're gonna stand in front of it at different places. We envision this being at malls or metro stations, anywhere where there's some high traffic. What we've seen is to do this in five major cities that we're thinking of outlining for you is that Montreal, Quebec City, Toronto, Edmonton, and as well as Vancouver. And what they would do is they would stand in and be able to have it analyze what they're wearing and then bring them suggestions on the side as the online platform would do, and they can use touchscreen to really select that outfit and also have it be mirrored and appeared on them. Like, for example, a Snapchat type filter, having that being able to show what it would look like on them so they can really style it the way they want when they're on the go. This is really going to be more interactive for them and really bring a greater engagement with the consumer. And it'll be a fun thing for them to do when they're on the go. We see the main things being have touchscreen dress selection, having in the bottom the hashtag dress it up. That way they can go, put the hashtag, and really continue the conversation online. And thirdly, a scannable QR code on these billboards so that they can be directed to the webpage to finalize their purchase of some of the items that they saw. Now, in terms of social media, we want to see this. We want to see an increase in the customer integration and engagement with Boutique 2018. Now, what we want to be doing is we want you to create interactive owned media for your customers, as well as sharing testimonials and experiences. So how we see this on Facebook and Instagram, we see this going by having sponsored posts and really using lookalike targeting. So you already have a great database of current customers that love your brand. So really being able to use them as that target, like you mentioned, those Sarahs, those Mandys, and those Stephs, to really help retarget specifically to them to help with their targeting. For Twitter, we want to really use this as a way to respond to customer service relationships that people have and to really keep that conversation going with your hashtag dressitup. Now, in terms of the influencer campaign, what we want to do is we understand that your consumers, they like people that are more relatable to them. A lot of them aren't a fan of these big influencers with tons of followers because it's not realistic to them. So what we suggest is we have an influencer campaign where you're going to be sharing their experiences both with the new website and the new technology of the stylus feature. And how they're going to be doing this is really sharing and reaching out to some of your target customers. Really, we're going to be focusing on going for some smaller influencers, as this really caters more towards your target. And as an example, we see an account such as Stains of Sunshine, which currently has 8,500 followers, who really does more lifestyle and fashion posts that are more geared towards this everyday woman. And now we're seeing this by going after 10 influencers, and we're thinking of going between 5,000 and 50,000 as a range of following to keep it in that smaller, more local size range. Now in terms of the purchasing phase, moving on to the future. What we see about this is leveraging your data. Now by doing these pictures and images, you're going to be gaining a lot of data from your customers through these customer profiles. And what we suggest for the future is to continue to create this fashion that's really perfect for the customer's style. By really getting and utilizing some of these pictures, you can use this to really better predict some future lines as inspiration. Because now, we see there's trends happening in the industry. But by utilizing this, these are actually images and different styles that these women, your target market, actually enjoy. So by really being able to leverage this, you can really cater to your direct target consumer in a better and more concise way. And for this, we see a metric of being the numbers of pictures submitted to see how this is going to go through in terms of how the engagement is working. Now in terms of the timeline, this is going to be through a year period, so the first 6 months building up before the launch, as well as after launch, which we can go in more in the Q&A period.
So in terms of key performance indicators, we managed to create a funnel as to how exactly, for example, the Facebook-sponsored posts will be utilized in order to convert from visit to sales. So using the sponsored posts and the budget we've invested in the sponsored posts, we managed to double the number of Facebook users you currently have, up to 475,000. We're planning on investing $15,000 to $20,000 in order to reach them five times, in order to create a cost per impression of approximately $2.3 million. Now, the average revenue per user is going to be around the $400, given the fact that you provided us with the data of saying 160 per cart. Well, these are going to be recurring purchases, and we're expecting them to purchase approximately $400 per year. That, of course, is a very pessimistic approach, but really we're expecting it to be a lot higher, but for the sake of these numbers, we'll keep it at 400. Now, we're expecting a 2% conversion rate, increasing the number from 1.6 up to 2%, given the fact that this technology will actually entice a lot of consumers to purchase your products, to eventually reach an additional 9,500 additional users, which will generate $3.8 million. So it's really important to focus on the conversion rate, which is really an increase from 1.6% to 2%, as that capacity can also, using the data, be leveraged to increase that conversion rate even more and more, really positioning your brand at the heart of women's wear, which is part of our recommendation. So moving forward in terms of the budget, really the largest expense in the budget comes from website technology and digital purposes. But we can expand more over the term. So finally, why were we here today? We're here to develop a digital marketing strategy to really promote strategy boutique in a very interactive way, given these three key metrics and those key considerations. Our recommendation, My Boutique, really takes that into consideration, your browsing, fitting, and picturing. We thank you very much for your time, and now open the floor to questions.
Today, because you wanted to launch in September, and we did see it as needing development before the month of September. So your launch on month 7, well, like at the end of month 6, is September, and you're here today.
Cool. I think I see a lot of things around customer experience and acquisition. What would be your strategy for retention?
So this. This initiative as a whole, we see it as being a great alternative for retention as well, because every time your customers are going to see something they want, they can continuously go onto your website and find it. As well, they will be receiving targeted ads from Facebook and Instagram, as well as potentially emails, since you do have 50,000 emails from your email list, so you can continue utilizing that for retention.
Oh, and you have also a target of 80% increase in terms of sales in store, 15% in store. So what's your strategy to do that, basically?
So the main strategy in terms of the in-store sales was the billboards, where people, once they walk into the store, they'll be able to actually use the billboards interactively to look at what they like. And if ever, for example, they don't have that specific size, they can just add to cart and purchase. It's really going to be a huge display as to what exactly is this technology, which will push them forward to come into the store. Also, that added factor of having all the Facebook and influencers will, the moment they pass in front of the Boutique 2018, we'll create that relationship being, oh, I remember this, saying I saw Stains of Sunshine posted, I'm going to walk in and see the store.
Could you go back quickly to the budget slide? Good. I think those are very interesting ideas, but I think it's with the given budget, it's a bit ambitious. So if you had to choose 3 or 4 of those tactics in order to fit within the budget limit, what would you focus on?
So all of these budgets are, for example, in terms of influencers and sponsored posts, we can, of course, decrease those numbers in order to give more advantage to content creation and website technology.
Okay.
As an overall strategy, this is what is necessary in order to be able to accommodate, but the numbers are variable in terms of how exactly do we refilter the money first generated in the first month in order to accommodate for the upcoming months. So our financial model predicted, for example, an initial $1 million in terms of increase within the first 3 months upon launching the app, while 500,000 of those can be refiltered in order to accommodate for this budget. But ultimately, it would be in terms of sponsored posts, influencers, and maybe the discount accommodation can be decreased, but not completely.
I'd like to go back to the interactive displays, please.
Mm-hmm.
You're mentioning that those displays will be inside malls, metro stations, and stores. Obviously, people won't be naked in those places, so they will already be dressed.
Mm-hmm.
Aren't you afraid that maybe this technology couldn't recognize the right size and give you the right fit for your money?
So what we see this being is a way to really promote it and promote the online app where you can really send in your picture. So the fact that it's really to show that you can make this selection, the fact that you can try it on and be fitted, it's really going to be superimposed on you. So the fit may not be exact, but we just want to do it in a fun, comical way so they can really see it and really get more of a gauge of what it would look like. And really the focus is more seeing the selection. So to show that if you scan your outfit, here's a selection of dresses that cater to this style that is what you're wearing currently. And that's what we're really going to be focusing on going forward with the additions to the website.
So suggestions will be made depending on how you dress at the moment or where you're scanning.
Yeah, exactly.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.